Hello friends, this video on force and pressure part 8 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So with this we have discussed about force. Now our discussion will remain incomplete if we do not talk about pressure. So by now you have understood what is force and what are the different types of forces which exist. So let us talk about pressure. So what is pressure? Now, pressure is nothing but force per unit area. Now, you might wonder that why suddenly are we talking about pressure? We already discussed about force and we talked about the various types of force. Why do we want to talk about pressure? That is because the amount of force which we apply and the amount of impact which we get, many a times that differ. Like, let us suppose you are pushing a wall with the same amount of force and you are pushing a small book with the same amount of force, but the impact or the result of both the efforts are extremely different. The wall doesn't move a bit, but the book might move a very large distance. So the impact of, in order to understand the impact that applied force will have, we should talk about pressure, because it also depends on the amount of area on which the force has been applied. So I will take some examples here. So as per this definition, pressure is equal to force divided by area. So let us take the example of a needle and a thick blunt cylindrical rod. Now what happens if I pinch a needle on your skin? So in the first example, what do you see? It is a sharp pointed needle. Now if I try to prick you through this needle, what will happen? You will feel the pain because it actually penetrates inside your through your skin. Now if I repeat the same activity, I just replace the needle with a thick blunt cylindrical rod, maybe the back side of your pencil, and now I try to pinch your skin with that thick blunt rod. In that case, what happens? You do not get that much hurt. In the first case, you might start to bleed, you might get pain, but in the second case, nothing like that. But the amount of force which you have applied in both the cases is the same. So the applied force is the same. So what has changed? Only the area has changed. So here, if you look at the cross-sectional area of the needle, that is very less when compared to the cross-sectional area of this blunt cylindrical rod. So that means in this case, the area is less. In this case, area is more. Now, force is same in both cases. So here also it is F, here also it is F. So what would be the pressure in this case? This will be force by area. So here also pressure will be equal to force by area. If you compare both of these, force is same in both of them, but area is less here and area is more here. So now here, what do you see? Pressure is inversely proportional to area. So if area is less here, so that means pressure will be more. And in this case, since area is more, therefore pressure will be less. Now, since pressure is less, that is the pressure exerted by the pencil or by this thick cylindrical rod. Since the pressure is less, therefore the pain that we felt is also less. But in this case, the pressure is more, therefore the pain felt or the impact is also more. So this is why we are talking about pressure, because if we want to know the impact of force, we will have to talk about area, because we need to know that the force was applied on how much area. Now once we know that, we'll get an idea about pressure, and pressure helps us to identify the impact of the applied force. So by now we understood that pressure is something which tries to find out the impact of force by considering the coverage area, that means the area which is being covered by that application of that force. So we understood that since pressure is equal to force per unit area, therefore greater is the amount of force, greater would be the pressure, and greater would be the area, lesser would be the pressure. Now keeping this in mind, let us try to look at some of the important applications where we will see that how this concept helps us to understand why these different things happen. Have you ever observed people showing shows on lying on a bed of nails? So they very comfortably lie on a bed of nails and nothing happens to them, which sounds so surprising, because if you consider one single nail and if you try to put it into your leg, What happens? A single nail putting into your leg or feet or arm or anywhere. So one nail can actually cause a lot of bleeding. It can hurt you. It can cause you a lot of pain. And now here you have a bed of nails. So not only one nail, but so many nails put together. But the person is able to sleep over it. I mean, he is able to lie down over it so comfortably. So how is that happening? Is there any magic behind it? Not really. This is a simple concept of pressure. Now what happens is, when you just try to put one single nail, in that case, if you consider the scenario of a single nail. So for a single nail, what happens is, you are just considering one pointed object. So the area here, the coverage area here is very less. Now area is very less, therefore the pressure is very high. And when the pressure is very high, then the impact is very high. Impact in terms of the pain, the hurt. So everything is very high, and that is why the nail gets inside through your skin. And as it enters inside your body, it's going to cause you troubles. So that is the scenario of a single nail. Now you consider the scenario of a bed of nails. Now have you ever observed that in a bed of nails, all the nails are of exactly the same height? Now when all the nails are of exactly the same height, now you have small surface areas which are very close to each other. In this case, you just have this much area, a small area. But in this case, you have small surface areas which are very close to each other. So overall, it makes a bigger surface area. So when you have a bed of nails where all the nails are of the same height and they are located quite close to each other, so the overall surface area increases. So the overall surface area in case of a bed of nails increases. Now when the surface area increases, the pressure decreases. When the pressure decreases, the impact also decreases. Now, whenever somebody shows you a magic of this kind, just try to ask him that, can I replace one nail with another nail which is of a bigger height or a smaller height? The person would not agree. That's because if you have nails of different heights, in that case, your effective surface area will not increase because not all of them are at the same level. So only few of them will be at one level. So whenever you try to lie down on it, so because of lesser surface area, the pressure will be more and the impact will also be more. So this is why lying on a bed of nails also do not cause any harm, because all the nails are of the same height and they are kept very close to each other, so that the overall surface area increases and the pressure decreases. Similarly, you think of an example of cutting vegetables with a knife or cutting a loaf of bread with a knife. Which kind of a knife will you prefer? A blunt one or a sharp one? Obviously a sharp one. That's because a sharp knife will have a lesser surface area. So sharp knife will have a lesser surface area. Therefore, the pressure will be more and therefore the impact will be more. If pressure is more, the cutting the bread or cutting vegetables will become easier. Think of the school bag. Have you ever observed that the strap of the school bag is always quite thick? And why do you have this thick strap? That's because the school bag is quite heavy, right? So, and that weight is going to be carried by your shoulders. Now, if the strap is quite thick, that means the area is going to be more. If area is more, the pressure is going to be less. So the pressure on your shoulders is going to be less. So your shoulders are going to feel less pain while carrying this heavy bag. So that is why the backpacks or the school bags, they always have thick straps. So these are some examples where you see that this very simple concept of pressure helps you to understand so many things which keep on happening around you. Let us look at few more examples. Have you ever seen the porters in the railway stations who just keep running behind you in order to carry your luggages? Now, if you have observed them, you would have also observed that they put a cloth over their head before they put any other luggage like suitcase or any other box. So first they put a piece of cloth over their head, and on that top of that cloth they keep the luggage. Now what happens due to the presence of this cloth? So now this cloth increases the area of contact. So the area of contact between the box and the head of the person. So this area of contact increases. Now when area increases, what happens to pressure? So the pressure tends to decrease, and when the pressure decreases, the pressure of this heavy box on the person reduces, and therefore it becomes easy to carry. Let us look at one last example of pressure. So think of this example, which might be a very common example in your day-to-day life. Let us suppose you want to you want to construct something using different wooden parts or different parts of steel. So how do you fix them all together? With the help of nails. And why do you choose nail? Because they have a pointed end like this. And it is not an easy stuff to put in blunt things. So we want tiny things with pointed ends. Now what do you do with these kind of small pins, small and sharp pins? Now when you apply a force, so you are basically applying it over a very small area because the area of contact is very less. Now when the area is very less, so the pressure becomes quite more because you are applying a force, and that force per unit, that area of the tiny nail, that is pressure. So the pressure is very high, and when the pressure is very high, then it becomes easy to put that pin inside. So that is how it helps in kind of jobs also. So that is the concept of pressure. So pressure tells us that the impact of force also depends on the area on which the force is acting. Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.